Hi everyone, my name is Bilal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. In this video, we are going to learn about state in Jetpack Compose. So the first question is, what is state? So a state is, in your application, any value that can change over time. Let's say, for a very basic example, we will take an application that displays a text in the screen. Now the value for this text changes over time. Let's say we are displaying three values in this text. And these values are, for example, A, B, and C. That means we have three states for the application. The first state is when the value displayed is A, and another states are the value displayed is B and C. So whenever the value is changed, we need to reflect this updated value to the UI, and that is what we are going to see in this video. So let's come back to our project, and it is the last project that we were working on. And in the last video, we learned creating a list in Jetpack Compose, or a recycler view, you can say. So this is our project, and we have the list that we displayed in the last video. Now, in this case, we are using this list of users. So we have this data class and we have this list. This is an immutable list. But let's say we have a mutable list for this example. And because it is mutable now, and we can add new items to this list, and we can also remove users from this list. So what if after running the application, we change the users list? That means we can add more users or we can remove existing users. But in this case, nothing will happen when the users list is changed. So our task is to update the UI whenever the users list is changed. And to do this, in our composable function, we can store an object. And to store an object in our composable function, we can use another composable function that is called remember. So let's see how we can do it. So inside this user list function, what I will do is I will create a val. Let's say we want to store name, and I can use this remember composable function to create a name. Now inside this remember composable function, I can store a name, but to store a name, I will use mutable state of, because whenever the value of this name is changed, I want to recompose my UI. That means the updated value will be reflected in the UI, and that is why to invoke a recomposition whenever the value is changed, I am creating a mutable state of inside remember. So I can create, let's say, my name inside this mutable state of. So this mutable state of accepts the default value as the parameter. So this is the first value whenever this user list is composed. Now whenever the value for this name is changed, the user list will be recomposed automatically, and we will always see the updated value in our UI. So the same concept we will use with users list. So right now, to show you all, what I will do is I will create list with one item, and at the bottom I will create a button, and whenever we will click that button, we will add a new item to our list. So let's see how we can do it. So for now, I will delete everything, this remember as well, and these comments. So we have user list, we have user card, and we have everything. Now what I will do is I will pass this users list to my user list composable function. So I will pass users list of user like this, and I will delete this users like this, and I will remove this user list from my set content, because this time with the list I want to display a button as well, where we will click to add a new item to our list. So I deleted the user list from the set content, and everything else is fine. And here also I will delete this user list in the preview function. Now what I will do is I will create one more composable function that will act as my main content. So I will write composable and I will create a function that is main content like this. And inside this function, I will create a box, and inside this box, I will write user list. Now it takes list of users. So for now I will pass an empty list and later I will provide actual value. So we have user list, and for the next item, I will pass a button where we will click to add new item to our list. So we have button, and inside onClick, we will add new item to the list. For now, I am leaving it empty. And for the button text, I will create a text and I will write the text as add more like this. So we have button, we have user list, and I will call this function inside my set content. So I have main content like this, and inside the preview as well, I will call main content. Now to create a list that our composable function will remember, I will again use remember function. So what I will do is I will create a val users, and I will use remember like this. And inside remember, what we will do is we will create a mutable state list of. So we need to use this function because we want to create a mutable state. That means whenever the value is changed, the composable function will be re-invoked, or basically it will recompose the UI. So this is my mutable state list of for list. For any single value, you can use mutable state of. But in this case, it is a list. That is why I am using mutable state list of. Now for the initial parameter, I will pass a user. So let's create a user first. That is my first user or default user. So we have a user. I will pass the ID as one. Now this user I can pass here as the default value or the first value. So initially we will see one item in our list. So this is users, and here instead of this list of, what I will do is I will pass users. Now whenever the button is clicked, we can add new user or a new user to the users list. But let's just build and refresh for now to see whether it is working fine or not. So we have the user card. We have only one item because initially we are passing only one user. Then we have this add more button, and I will put this button at the bottom center. So what I'll do is I will pass a modifier to my button. So I will write modifier, and then I will pass modifier, and I can also pass padding, let's say padding of 24 dp. And then I will pass alignment. So we use this function align, and I will put it on a separate line so that you can see it clearly. So we have padding and then we have align. And for the alignment, I will pass bottom center like this. Now let's build and refresh. So we have this add more button here and we have the list. Now, whenever we will click on this add more button, we will get a callback here inside the on click. So we have the on click here. This is our on click. And inside on click, what we can do is we can add new items or a new item to our users list. So what I will do is I will simply write here users dot add, and I will pass a new user like this here. So we have the new user added to the list, and because the list is of mutable state list of, this main content will be recomposed and we will see the newly added item in our list. So let's see if it is working or not. So I will run the application now. So let's run it. So you can see this add more button is coming above our card, but it will work. So let's click this button. And it is working absolutely fine. You can see we are seeing the new items in our list or recycler view, whatever you consider it. So it's working fine. I will just put this add more at the bottom, and to do this, what I will do is for the box, I will pass a modifier, and I will pass the modifier that is called fill max size. And let's run the application again. So you can see we have the button at the bottom, and if I click the button, I am getting new items in my list. So it is working absolutely fine, as you can see. So this is how you can update your Jetpack Compose UI whenever the state of your application is changed. I hope you found this video helpful and learned something. In case you have any problem, confusion or questions, you can leave it in the comments below. So please like this video and subscribe to Simplified Coding if you're not already a subscriber, and I will see you in the next video. So thanks for watching, everyone. This is Belal Khan now signing off.